Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Chair McWilliams, I understand that when you first came to the United States, you only had $500 in your pocket.
I did.
And you used that $500 to open a checking account and, importantly, get a secured credit card. You stated that, quote, with each swipe of that credit card, I felt more integrated into the very fiber of American society, close quote. So do banks get CRA credit for offering a secured credit card?
I have to actually go, to tell you the truth, the answer is not that simple. You have to go through a complex formula to figure out what qualifies and not under the CRA.
Let me share with you that according to the Government Accountability Office, banks that offer secure credit cards designed to establish or rebuild credit histories receive credit under the CRA. So what we have here is a real-life example of someone benefiting from the CRA. You yourself said that this secured credit card opened up, quote, a world of opportunities for you. So I would hope that as you decide how to move forward on potential changes to the CRA, that you'll take to heart the need to strengthen the CRA so that more Americans can benefit from this important civil rights law, just as you did when you first came to the United States. So let me relay one concern I have with how things are going. Recently, Politico reported that the FDIC could give the smaller banks it regulates the choice of opting into this new OCC-led CRA regulatory framework or continuing to be examined under the current system. That could lead to a situation where banks themselves choose to participate in the model that gives them the best grade and not the one that best measures whether their activities are effectively addressing the needs of their communities. If adopted, do you know what percentage of FDIC-regulated banks would have the choice to opt into the OCC approach?
So the proposal is still being worked on. One of the options we considered was the opt-out for small banks, opting into the new regime or keeping the existing regime. The main reason for the opt-in opportunity would be to provide an ability for small banks not to have to change their reporting requirements and their how they go through the analysis of what qualifies for the CRA. Small banks, the number of small banks, if they decide to opt in, would depend on what threshold we pick for the cutoff.
So you don't know yet what number because you haven't decided on the threshold.
It's not firm. We are looking at numbers and making
sure. But I hope that other than, you know, we want small banks, yes, to have less less necessity in terms of paperwork, but we don't want them to have less necessity or obligation in terms of creating a portal of opportunity.
I agree with you.
Under the CRA. If most FDIC-regulated banks would be able to opt in, then aren't you, if that's what happens, then aren't you simply making a political calculation that best protects the interests of the banks you're charged with regulating over those who stand to benefit from a strong CRA rule? Isn't, in essence, the threshold going to determine whether that's the reality or not?
No, actually, it is not. The reason that I am willing to consider reform to the Community Reinvestment Act is because the act has not been revisited since 1995 by the regulators. And Congress, you gave us the authority to take a look at the act and make sure it serves its intended purpose. Currently, we have digital delivery channels for banks that are not necessarily accounted for appropriately in the current assessment areas. The way that the deposit taking now takes place is everything gets attributed to a branch. And now it would be the digital channels. Excuse me, there's a lot of deposit taking that's taking place outside of this area. And we want to make sure that under the reform of the CRA, those areas where the digital banks are functioning and offering taking deposits and offering services are served by CRA.
Let me just say that age itself is not a reason to review the Act. Certainly to improve and strengthen the Act is something worthy. But you don't want to, at the end of the day, use the time in which the Act has not been reviewed to weaken it. So I'm concerned that you're all trying to have it both ways, not fully endorsing the flawed OCC plan that allows most of the FDIC-regulated banks to choose which system they're measured under, but also not standing up and fighting for a better CRA standard than what Controller Oding has proposed. So I hope that the end result is that I'm wrong on that, but I'm going to be looking with incredible intensity.
I look forward to proving you wrong, Senator.
I'm always happy to be proven wrong when it's benefit of consumers.